and I'm going to be talking tonight about advantages of enemies.
Advantages of enemies. Enemies. I want to hear that one.
Yes, yes, it's very important that every one of us should know the advantages of enemies in our lives.
Okay.
You know, there was a night I spoke to God. I was so aggressive in the place of prayer, and I told God, I said, this night, Father, I want you to destroy all the enemies of my life. Let them all die. And suddenly I had a voice of God say, shut up. I'm not going to kill all of them. I can destroy some, but not all. I said, why? He said, because they are good for you.
Really?
That's the first time I hear that from God.
He said, really?
Yeah, yeah. He said, Father, how do you mean enemies are good for me? He said, absolutely, they are good for you. So I'm not going to kill all of them, because they have certain things they have to do in your life. There are certain missions they have to fulfill in your life, which are done so good. I arrange it. I plan it so it can help your journey of faith. And I say, yeah, Holy Ghost, go ahead and tell me more about this. In fact, I stopped praying that night. And I have to sit down with my Bible and start listening to what God has to tell me about having enemies in my life and their advantages in my life. And that is what I'm going to be sharing tonight with our listeners. And I believe it will bless them.
Amen.
Because if you don't have enemy, that means you are nothing in life. You are nobody in life. But once you are somebody and especially you are making impact, just get set. You must have enemy. So why are those enemies in your life? Those are the things I want to tell you. And why God permits them to be. God is not going to kill all the enemies of your life. It doesn't matter how many days fasting you embark on, and even if you like go on dry fasting from January to December expecting God to destroy all of your enemies. The truth is, if some die today, new ones come tomorrow. You know the magic. So get set for enemies. They are good. Enemies are not bad product. They are not bad facilities. They are meant to bless you in life. And these are some of the things I want to share with you, the advantages of enemies in your life.
Okay.
Number one. Can I go on?
Yes, please.
So, number one advantages of enemies is that enemies actually enhance your what I call sensitivity.
I'm writing this down.
Good. Enemies enhance your sensitivity. Good. Without enemy in your life, you can never know how to be sensitive in life. One of the reasons why God permits enemy is to breed your sensitive ability, to enhance your sensitivity. When you've got enemy in your life and somehow they have wounded you before, or they've attacked you before, or they have caused a problem in your life before, you risk an important blessing in their attacking you, because you have to learn how to be sensitive next time, not to do things the way probably you did them before the enemy gets you. Now, if, for example, enemy has dealt with you before, you will learn not how to talk anyhow. You're going to be very careful, maybe because you have spoken a word that have implicated you. The enemy have used that word to implicate you somewhere, and that will give you what you call sensitivity to your utterance. You no longer talk blah blah anyhow. You don't babble anymore with your mouth. You have to be careful, knowing that there was a time you said a word that get you into the trap of the enemy, and that help you now to be sensitive in your speech. And I'm going to give you an example of something that happened sometime ago, and God said that's one of the things that happened when enemies strike you. Now listen, when you sit, for example, in a place before and an ant bite you in that place, the next time you come back to sit in that place, you notice you have to be very careful. You don't want to sit anyhow. As a matter of fact, even if a fly pass in front of you, you're going to be careful, because an ant has ever beat you before. So that help you to be very sensitive to anything that crop around your life, because you have been beaten before by an enemy. So enemies are good because they make you very sensitive. They make you extremely very sensitive. Another advantages of enemy is that they ginger your smartness. Enemy make you to be very smart in life. I'm telling you the truth. If you don't have enemies, you are going to be too relaxed.
That's
you're not
true.
Going to be
that is
at
true.
Oh, you are not going to be smart in life.
You'll be praying, you'll be doing night vision again.
Now, I'm still coming to that. I have found out in my life that those times that enemy come against me like a flood, I develop some extraordinary prowess in my life. I become absolutely intelligent. And that is one of the things I must say, that enemy will help you to be smart. You are not going to be relaxed. You're not going to be dull. If you are in a class and you have an enemy, you don't want to fail in that class. Because you know you have somebody in that class who don't like you, already announced to people that you are dull, that
so
you are not intelligent, so you want to prove him wrong.
Yeah.
So because of the presence of that enemy, you're going to work on yourself to be sure that you doesn't fail. Why? Because that enemy is there to ginger your smartness. That's one of the advantages of enemy. One of the advantages of enemies, again, is that enemy exposes you to your greater level in life. Enemies, true enemies, you get to know who exactly you are in life. Honestly speaking, if you don't have enemy, you don't know who you are.
Wow.
Now, enemy tells you, even when you don't know, that you are a great person. person, the amount of attack you receive sometimes begin to tell you that, look, if you are not somebody, there is no cause for all of this enemy fighting you. Thank you. So enemies reveal who you really are to you. That's why God allowed them sometimes to show you who you really are, even when you don't know that you are a great person. And that's why I love what someone said, that the size of your enemy indeed reveal the size of your destiny.
Wow.
And that is actually true. So the size of the enemy that come around you tells you who you really are. So enemies are made also to show you your next level of life. Enemies are very good in your life. And the next thing I will say about advantages of enemy is that enemies are boosters of supplication fire. I really like this so much.
Boosters
of your supplication life. I want to tell this categorically that without enemy, many Christians will never pay again. They will never pray.
It's
I'm
true.
Telling you
I
the
agree.
Truth. The, check your life, and I've checked my life. The time I pray most in my life are the time I am being attacked by enemies.
Okay.
And that is just the truth.
Yeah.
The time I give my best energy to prayer that I know that really I pray are the time I am faced with a lot of aggressive attack from the camp of the enemy. And that is why sometimes when your prayer life is going down and then you are getting too chilly in the things of the spirit, now you know what God do? God allow enemies to come in.
I can relate.
Yes, yes. They come in massively to attack you on every side.
I say, oh, let me fast.
And that time you begin to think about fasting. In fact, you can go extra mile. But when all is well with you, you even really fast to 12.
You find it difficult
to fast to 12 noon when all is well. But when the enemy attack you, you don't
fast
know.
To six.
In fact, when you get to six, you don't want to stop.
You do dry.
You keep grooming. Father.
Just laughing, but you know, it's very true.
Yes, because
true.
The enemies are all around. So anytime the Lord observes his children are getting so relaxed in the things of prayer, maybe they are no longer calling him, they are no longer taking their prayer life serious, you know, God just opened doors for enemy to come in.
Wow.
And when they come in, he knows your prayer life is going to rise up immediately.
Yes, so,
and before
fast.
You know, you begin to fast and you begin to talk to God. And so that's why God allowed the enemy. God told me one night, he said, son, it's like you're getting too relaxed, isn't it? All right, don't worry, I'm going to spoil you up. And truly, some attack came. And when they came, before you know, the anointing came to pray.
Mm-hmm.
And God said to me, yes, this is why I can't take off all the enemies. This is why I can't kill all your enemies. Because if I kill all of them, you're not going to pray anymore. You're going to be too relaxed. So that's why you need them. So they can keep you praying. They can keep boosting the fire of your supplication life. And that's why I'm telling my listener tonight that enemies are good. So it's not every time that they are bad. They are still good. They still have advantages because they boost your supplication life. Another one I love about enemy is that enemies are sweetener of success celebration.
Wow.
I call them sweetener of success celebration. Do you know what? Mm-hmm. Anytime you succeed, do you know the first person you would like to see?
Yeah, your enemy.
Your enemy. Don't you imagine that?
To see their face.
You know, when you succeed, it's not your friend that you want to see first.
It's true.
Because your friend believes in you. Mm-hmm. Your friend know you're going to succeed yourself. Your friend love your success. But the first person you want to see when you succeed are your enemies.
Hmm.
Those people who have told you that you will never succeed.
Exactly.
Those
that
people who have written you off.
Ah,
those people who have written you off in life. Who have concluded that you are not going to be anything.
Hmm.
That's why in the scripture, when Joseph succeeded, you know, when his brothers show up, because they are his enemies, he looked at them, tears of joy rolled down. He turned back. He was so excited because these are the people that intended to kill him.
Wow.
These are the people that wanted to extirpate his life, that want to get rid of him. And here they are to see that this day God has exalted
him.
True. And so they are really sweet now of success celebration. You know, anytime you succeed, that enemies are not there, you are not really for fear. You just that's why David said, he has anointed me in the presence of my enemies.
Enemies
and my cup run over. What a good thing to celebrate your success in the presence of your enemy. So enemy are good. One of their advantages is that they make success sweet for you to celebrate when they are around. And then you just look at that person, and the person cannot look back to you eyeball to eyeball.
Yeah.
And sometimes some of them pretend, and then you just smile and then I say, hello. I know you thought I'm gonna fail in life, but here is it, God has made me succeed.
Uh-huh.
And then you are just so fulfilled and so excited. So God will have to spare some enemy so they can live to see you really succeed in life. Enemy are down so good in time of success celebration.
I'm sure somebody is listening
I got another one I really love too, that enemy are going to move you to your next level, of comfort.
Yes.
You know where I landed from Isaac while he was in Gerar? They gang up together and say, we don't like this man here, get out of our land. And then the Philistines sent Isaac out of their land. He came to Sitna, he came to Esek. They fought him. Enemies say, you can't stay here, get out, until finally he came to Rehoboth.
Yeah.
The place that the Bible said, and now the room has been made for him and the land became fruitful. So without enemy, there is nowhere Isaac will have gotten to Rehoboth of his life. And that I have discovered, that until enemies are in operation in your life, there are places God wants you to get to that you never get there. You so much get you to some level that you think this is the best for you. And God said, this is not the best. And even if God is saying, get out of here, move to the next level, you don't want to go. Because you are too used to the comfort zone of that place. And God is going to use the enemy to wipe you out and send you out. Wow. But at the end of it, it's not to destroy you, it's to take you to a better place in life. And that has happened to so many people, but they never knew that God allow them, because you want to bless them, you want to take them to a higher level of your life. Sometimes where you are walking, sometimes they just gang up and some conspiracy come up, and maybe they even sack you, or they even say, okay, we'll retrench you. God permit that because he has a better job for you. I remember a young lady who her boss said, I'm gonna sack you, and she did everything to beg. You know why I want to sack her? Because you want to sleep with her, and she never agreed to sleep with her. And then he said, okay, I'm gonna fire you, and suddenly he fired her. She cried, you know, she begged, she did everything. She don't want to lose that job because that's her hope, just like she said. But the man fired her. And you know what happened? 6 months after he fired her, an international organization employed her.
So sad.
And then before you know, 6 times better than where she left.
Oh, wow.
And the company has to do with where she left, whereby they have to come from where she left to buy some stock.
Oh,
from
God.
Where she was. And the manager has to come there to buy stock. And she is now the one, the sales manager in charge of that new.
That's a Joseph moment. Here.
Thank you. So, and then she looked at him and said, you are welcome. And then he looked at her and said, madam, how are you?
Madam.
Yes, he called her madam. Because now she's superior to him. Just for him to see that that was the lady he shot. Because he wanted to sleep with her. But God brought her to a better place. You see, God used him as an enemy to bring her to her better level of her life.
That's true.
I'm encouraging somebody tonight. Maybe there is a conspiracy like this going on, and they're trying to sack you. They're trying to fire you. Not because you did something wrong. But because God just allowed it, because he wanted to take you to another
next level.
You have fasted, you have prayed, you have beg them, and they are not hearing you. God said, don't move. I allow those enemies to do that because I want to take you to a better level of life. So you're going to celebrate very soon that God allowed enemy to force you to a higher level, a more comfortable level than where you are. So enemy are really, really good for our life. They are good. I really celebrate having enemies sometime in my life, because I see that God has used them to bring me to the better place of my life. So I talk to someone tonight, celebrate the enemies in your life. They are good for you.